to walk as much as I can, and I definitely don't walk every day. But when I do, I take my Congo with me, my guard dog. Hey, sit, be good. As you can see, he's excited. sit, donkey. He does not listen, he's excited. So I like to take Congo for a walk with me. And normally when I walk, I always like to walk and run past some of the properties that I own. Because it motivates me, shows me how far I have come. In this suburb alone, I own $20 million worth of properties. And this dirt is real. No offense to my friends that are playing with crypto, but this is real. And over time, this does go up in value and you can feel it. And I love walking past. I like reminding myself how far I have come by just being there. So in the mornings when I walk, there's quite a few places I just walk past and see what's happening. And this specific block of land, I purchased it 6 months ago with 3 months settlement, and I paid $4,500,000. And vision was to chop it up into four blocks and not sell it when subdivision is done. So after buying it for $4.5 million, spent $220,000 on stamp duty. First thing after I settled it was seeing my town planner. And my town planner was the one that was doing all the development approval. While he was doing development approval, I also organized approval for old house to be demolished, which we did the second that we got approval, which took us about 5 days. Then took us about 3 months to get approval to chop this into four blocks. And now we put it on the market. So $4.5 million plus $220,000. Stamp duty, another $180,000 worth of operational works. So $4.5 to $5 million, I'm turning it into $8 million. And my money is gonna be locked in for about 8 to 9 months time. So it's not a bad project. So I feel fucking proud to walk on this dirt. Just to remind a lot of you, I'll probably take you for a drive today to show you where I started and what is fucking possible. I did start from nothing. Coming here as a refugee when I was 16, living in a house commission. Now I'm walking my dog and standing on one of my properties in a great location. Anyway, let's start with the day, shall we? Go back to walking and then start. My construction sites before I get to my office, and we're just driving now to I own that home as well. Actually, I just bought it for 1.9 million month ago, but now we are driving to an older home that I purchased literally 2 weeks ago. I settled on it 2 weeks ago. I paid $2.5 million, and I'm doing a massive renovation on it. And I'm gonna put it on the market for $5 million once it's finished. And target is to actually get the reno done in 3 months time. So we just started demolishing everything, which you'll be able to see in a second. And you'll see what this home is gonna look like in 3 months time as well. So my morning routine is, I try to go to my development site. So if I'm building anything at the time, before I actually get to my office and before I start my real estate day. And my real estate day, the way it usually starts is I get a brief from our COO. She gives me a brief what's happening with all of our 10 real estate offices. Then I have a quick meeting with my personal team that are my three right-hand men and women, Chi, Nan, and Ming. Because I still sell a lot of luxury real estate, and this year I aim is to sell $300 million worth of real estate. And then I have a brief from them as well, and then I see what meetings I have to go to. So that's my day. And then in between, I also got another business that I will show you guys as well. So this is one of my developments here. They tell you read this, eat this, don't look around, just peep this, preach this, teach us Jesus. Okay, look up now, they done stole your streetness. After all of that, you receive this. Good morning. I'm going now for a listing appointment. I think the house is worth about $3 million. And my assistant, she has prepared all the paperwork, so I'm just gonna pick it up from the office quickly, and then we are off to our first listing presentation. Now I have to be a real estate agent, have to put that cap on. Why do I sell real estate? Many people ask me. Well, when I decided to start a real estate company almost 6 years ago, I said I'm gonna lead by example. So that is the best way to attract other real estate agents to join my company, other real estate agents, and other principals to join NGU brand, if I'm fucking good at it. Also, if I wanna train other people, how can I train them if I'm shit at it myself? So I have to be one of the best. Right now, last 12 months, I have sold $160 million worth of real estate. Next 12 months, I'm trying to sell $300 million. On top of running 10 real estate offices, on top of running media company and a small law firm and a property development company that will develop over $50 million worth of real estate. So it's gonna be busy year. And I got one more business that I'm part of, which I will take you for the tour later today. Fucking exciting. But if you can manage everything you do and find people that are good at it and that are smarter than you are in their own fields, you can do many things. I got an incredible lady that's running my 10 real estate, well, offices. I got great capable manager that runs my media company, Earl. I got my brother that runs my development company. And then I got a great right-hand man, Nan Ming, and right-hand lady Chi, that runs, help me run real estate sales. So if you get organized, you can do many things, but you have to learn how to fucking let go and not do everything yourself and think to yourself that you are the best at everything. That was fantastic listing presentation. I will find out within a day or two if I actually got a job. I'm 100% confident I do get the job, or I did get the job, because I know I can market better than anybody else. Stay tuned, you'll be able to see next 3 days if I actually did win this. In the meantime, you can film this as well. I literally have 7 missed calls and I have 30 messages. Inspection. Sam is a very qualified buyer. He knows what he wants, and I think he sees value in the house.
if he does buy it, he will obviously do a lot of work to it, add value and potentially resell it in the future. Hi, going on? Hello?
Hey, how you doing?
Good, man, what's happening?
Good, how'd you go? All good?
Yeah, great inspection. Sam is a very qualified buyer. He's very keen. He's gonna bring his wife through over the next couple of days. And if she likes it, which I think she will, they will make an offer. So I think the offer is gonna come around. I think offer is gonna come around 5.5 million. So we'll see where we go from there. How did you go?
Yeah, good. So my inspection was fine. So I'm getting the offer. It's probably gonna be around that 1.7, 1.8 level.
That's okay. So that's a good start.
Yeah. So I'm back in the office now. I was just calling you. One of our sellers, Deb, she scheduled a meeting for you.
Yes, at 4:30.
I'm with her for a. Yeah, so you had a 5 o'clock or something. She was saying. So
yes,
she's can now you, at three o'clock in Helensvale. Can you make that?
Nah. While I'm here at the Gold Coast right now, is there any chance you can call her and ask her if I can actually meet them in the next 30 minutes?
Okay, I'll call her now.
So literally, see if they are happy for me to be there in 30 minutes flat.
Okay, I'll call her now.
Thanks, Dan. Bye. Roll up, drink it, I do that for me. I'm at Burley Heads now, and Burley Heads, if you ask me, it is the hottest real estate in Australia right now. And I got a feeling that every developer from Australia is literally at Burley Heads right now. It is absolutely madhouse. Real estate is that hot, it's unbelievable. And if you ask me, real estate is extremely scary here, and I'll tell you that in a second why. My phone keeps fucking ringing. Hang on. Hello?
Hey, yeah, all good, 12:30.
Okay, so I can meet them in 30 minutes.
Yes, yeah, at the house in 30 minutes.
Do you have an address?
Yeah, I put in your calendar, but I'll send it to you now.
Thank you.
Luke Callan's calling me.
Okay, bye.
Bye,
mate. The reason why it's dangerous, because I actually feel that if prices went up by 30% across Australia, or in Queensland, Brisbane, and Gold Coast, I feel like they have gone 45% in value here. But it's not just that. Reason why it's dangerous, I personally believe there's extremely gonna be big oversupply of apartments. Any developer that walked into Burley Heads at early stages, 2-3 years ago, Burley was just starting to take off, they're gonna do extremely well. But anybody that's walking there right now and construction prices going up, I'm afraid that a lot of them will be doing their ass. So a lot of people talk about crash. If the market does crash, I don't think it will, but if it does, Burley Heads will be one of those suburbs where you would see absolutely a fucking bloodbath. But hopefully that won't happen. But would I develop right now in Burley Heads? I would if I was starting, like I said, 2-3 years ago. Right this second, I would be extremely nervous. I would be very, very nervous entering Burley Heads right now, because by the time you finish your development, it would be 2-3 years from now. Interest rates will go up 4-5 times by that time. So I think would be very dangerous field, and I got a feeling that there would be oversupply of apartments in Burley. That is just my personal view. Risk is too high. And unfortunately right now, construction prices have gone up anywhere 10 to 30%. A lot of construction companies have gone under, unfortunately, and they were actually building quite few buildings on the coast for a lot of developers. Interesting. A lot of big development sites already closed by developers that have actually gone, by the builders that have gone under, and they couldn't actually finish the projects for any developers. One of the dangerous thing is, most of these apartment buildings that haven't started construction yet, most of them actually sold. you know, if there's a 20, 30, or 100 apartments in the building, they are pre-sold before construction even started. So people can get financed, but if the market goes down by 20%, by the time these buildings are fucking finished, banks will ask for valuation. And if the prices went down by 20%, most of these people that purchase these apartments specifically for investments, they will not be able to fucking settle them. Because if they bought something for $1 million, they were trying to buy it with using maybe 20% deposit, which is $200,000, based on hoping they're gonna have a valuation of $1 million. But what if the valuation comes down to $800,000? That means they need another fucking 20% from $800,000 to settle it, because valuation is a lot smaller than the original price that they had. Which means a lot of those buyers would be crashing the contracts, potentially losing their own deposit. But what the fuck do the builders do? Our developers do. Developers have funders. Funders want to have money repaid on time. If they can't repay it on time, they're going to be putting pressure on developers to dump the fucking stock. And that's why I think the building heads is extremely dangerous over the next 2-3 years. Because next 2-3 years in any fucking market is so unpredictable. Because interest rates will go up a few times, and that can put fear into buyers, and buyers won't have fear of missing out anymore. They must sit on their money more. Anyway, that's my 2 cents on it, and let's see what the fuck happens. Well, we definitely got the business. It's been a crazy busy day. We definitely got the job. Let me actually stop here so I can check my phone. We definitely got the listing.
Yeah.
What can I do for you?
I saw your Tesla story. And I want to do one to put up tomorrow. Beautiful. At East Brisbane House with the Tesla 3 thrown in.
And I'm throwing myself in as well.
Is that your house?
No, it's not. I'm just kidding. So I don't come in the house.
Okay.
No,
yeah, so what prompted that? Just put the Tesla in as well. That's like, I have never heard of that.
Yeah, well, what happened, the lovely clients, they called us to see their home, and they said they want to sell. And they said, look, because real estate market is hot and petrol is so expensive, why don't we make it even more attractive to buyers? The Tesla comes with the house as well. And obviously, you know, all of the talk is about petrol at the moment being so expensive that, you know, if you want to buy a Tesla at the moment, you really got to wait, you know, 9 to 12 months for Tesla. While a year ago, if you wanted to buy Tesla, you didn't have to wait for Tesla at all. You can get money within a week. Now, because there's such a big demand for Teslas, he just thought, which is a great idea, I think, as well, that would attract a lot more buyers as well, and he can really capitalize on it, that Tesla comes with the house, and it's also great marketing as well, because so many people are talking about it now.
And also, that's the sort of buyers that you're targeting, isn't it? Inner city, sort of professional. Those Teslas, they fit your bicycle in the back, all
100%,
sorts of things.
100%. I mean, look, the property is literally, you know, less than 5 minutes drive from CBD. And, you know, the Tesla kind of suits that lifestyle of inner city, where you actually don't have to drive too far and run out of your batteries, full stop. So, you know, it's super house. Even I own a Tesla as well, to be honest.
Oh, you got a Tesla now too. Gosh, that's your collection.
I got Tesla and many other things. But a lot of my other cars spends a lot of petrol. And Tesla makes me feel good about, saving this planet a little bit for a second. And saving.
So which one did you get? Have you got the 3?
Yeah, I got a 3 as well. I bought it last year.
Mm.
I highly recommend
it. Okay, excellent. And what about the fast charger? I'm interested in that. That's the one that's wall mounted. You can just
100%.
Yeah, all set up at home.
Yes, correct. So, for example, in my own house, I actually don't have fast charger, and takes forever to literally charge the Tesla. I need literally 15 hours for my Tesla to be charged. But in this specific home, it does have a fast charger, and the car is literally charged within no time. You know. less than 1 hour, you can literally go and drive your car again. So that's completely fully installed in the house as well. But besides that, it's actually really beautiful, low maintenance Hampton style home, so close to CBD. Yeah.
And is it a brand new build, or is that all renovation work?
No. The house is only a couple of years old. It's only about 2 years old. So it's relatively new home. And the people that own the house, they just decided that they want to get bigger home now, and that's the reason why they're selling.
Yeah. Okay. Is there anything else that you want to add? There's no auction thing. So is there like a price range you're looking at,
we are looking,
I can play there?
Yeah, sure. We are looking at the office interest around 2 million. 2 million plus. You can literally say 2 million plus.
Yeah, 2 million plus. Okay. Excellent. All right.
It's been great hearing from you. Anyway.
Yeah. You too. And all the best. And stay in touch. Eh?
Thank you very much. You've been great. Thank
you. Okay. Take care. Bye.
Bye.
No matter how long it takes.
Interesting fact about my office. I bought it 5 years ago when I was starting NG Real Estate. And when I bought it, I think I paid just under $4.2 million. I said, I'm going to create one of the larger real estate companies in Brisbane. 5 years later, NG Real Estate is on the track to sell $2 billion worth of real estate this year. How about that, hey?
No, it's on sight when I see you. I'm working at Squarespace.
Yeah, top of the morning. I know that you thought I was dormant. Woke up early from shots that was swarming a block.
Hey, some good looking people. And him, never have him on the camera. Otherwise, I'm going to lose every fucking follower I have on social media.
Oh, yeah. The bill's in front of me, actually.
That's Moses. He's
I better not
master.
Be in that.
Make sure you never film her.
I'll FaceTime
her. Huh? She doesn't like to be in the video. She, I can make you a celebrity. You can go to Hollywood. What about you, Ming? You got a face for TV. Who's that?
I actually am now, because I thought this whole bloody America trip was a fucking...
Chevy, how you going, buddy? Chevy, I can't fucking hear him. Get him off your headphones, you donkey.
Sorry, I thought you heard the inside the headphones.
Oh, you think I can hear inside your fucking
head? Joking, right?
Hey, Chevy.
Hey, brother.
You look much better on video than you do in real life. You ready for New York?
So I'm ready, man. I'm so sorry.
You ready, huh?
What is this?
Ready, man.
Can you read it?
Is that your attempt at drawing a CMS?
Yes.
22 hours.
It is.
Are you actually?
They haven't given me one.
Yeah, you guys have been playing for 22 hours.
20. Far out. That'll be alright.
4 more days.
We use the spreadsheet. 4 more days.
Say what? The stuff that I seen got me traumatized. I let the keg go and
I have to go for 1 hour drive, and my home is only 2 minutes away from the office. And Kurt wants to see how good my Porsche goes, my GT3. So he convinced me to go and swap cars, which I'm gonna lose 10 minutes and potentially make my buyer wait. Not good, so we have to speed. Just kidding, no speeding. All right, let's go.
Yo, G, they can't stop me from rapping, can they? Can they hop? I spit it through the wire, man. There's too much stuff on my heart.
We are seeing now another home. This one I put it on the market about 10 days ago. And right now, I've literally got four different buyers at the house. And one buyer is coming back for second time. So I'm actually hoping to get contract on the house and have it sold today. That is my aim. Look forward to it. Let's check it out.
Somebody order pancakes, I just sip the scissor. That right there could drive a sane man bizarre. Not to worry, Mr. Ace.
Welcome. I've seen many homes and I've sold many homes. This home really feels like a home, and there's not many places like this, full stop. Come check it out.
All I see is you. All I see is you.
12th of... Jason, what month is today? Oh yes, 12th of April, 18.8 million sold, and we're about to sell one property for 3,200,000, another property for 1.3 million, so it'll be about $22 million, first 12th day of the month. Boom, that's a wrap. I'm going home now. Actually, I'll be on the phone closing more deals, but that's it for now.